All right, in this problem, we're asked to find cosine of alpha plus beta, given some information about alpha and beta. Tangent of alpha is 5/12, and alpha lies between pi and 3 pi over 2, and sine of beta is negative 1/2, where beta lies between pi and 3 pi over 2 as well. Okay, so first of all, we're going to do this without using a calculator. And the first thing I note is that I have no idea what alpha and beta are, right? I can't think of an angle such that tangent of alpha is 5/12. Same deal with beta. So what we're going to do is we're going to make use of the sum formula for cosine, which says that cosine of the sum alpha plus beta, that's equal to cosine of alpha multiplied by cosine of beta minus sine of alpha times sine of beta. Now, you might not think that that helps us, or you might think that that doesn't help us at all, because we have no idea what alpha is, right? So how do we know what cosine of alpha is? But what we can do is we can get these quantities by using the given information. Now, the good news is that we already know one of these, right? We already know what sine of beta is. They tell us right off the bat that sine of beta is negative 1/2. So we've got this one. What we've got to do is find the rest of them, right? Sine of alpha, cosine of alpha, and cosine of beta. So let's just think about alpha for a moment. We know tangent of alpha is 5/12. Let's go ahead and think about that on another sheet. Tangent of alpha is 5/12. Okay, so writing that here. Now the other condition they gave us was that alpha lies between, right? It's greater than pi, but it's less than 3 pi over 2. And that means alpha has to lie in quadrant 3, right? Between pi and 3 pi over 2. So our alpha might look something like this, even though we don't know its value. So the alpha might be something like that. Now what's important to note is that, you know, whenever you're evaluating or finding the trig values of angles, what you need are three quantities, right? Or two out of the three, rather. But you need to know your x, your y, and your r. So an r is, of course, the radius of the circle under consideration. R does not have to be 1. That's only if you're thinking about a unit circle. In this case, we're not going to be using a unit circle, as you'll see. Now, tangent of alpha, in this case, yeah, it's 5 over 12, but generally speaking, I know that tangent of alpha is y divided by x. Okay, there's a very important observation that you have to make here. And it's that because even though y over x is equal to 5 over 12, that does not imply that y is equal to 5 and x is equal to 12. In fact, there are infinite combinations of y and x such that y divided by x will be 5 divided by 12, will be 5 over 12. And I can see that's relevant here, right? Because x and y, because the angle's in the third quadrant, x and y have to both be negative. X has to be less than 0, and same with y, because of this information. So, looking at that, I can say, well, wait a minute, that means y can be negative 5, and x can be negative 12. So these numbers, negative 5 and negative 12, not only do they satisfy this condition, right, that y divided by x is 5/12, they also satisfy these conditions, that they're both negative. Okay, so this combination will work. And then I can find my r, because I know that r squared is equal to, well, x squared plus y squared. So r squared is equal to, let's see, x squared is 144, and y squared is 25. So r squared is 169. Now that implies, of course, mathematically, just algebraically right here, that r is equal to positive or negative the square root of 169. But of course, remember, r is the radius of your circle. So r must be positive square root of 169. And of course, the square root of 169 is 13. Now, making use of x, y, and r, now you can find sine of the angle alpha. Why? Well, sine of alpha, I know, is y divided by r. And let's see, y is negative 5. and I found R to be 13. And likewise, cosine of the angle alpha is x divided by r. And x I found to be negative 12, and r is 13. Okay, so I found two out of my four quantities, sine of alpha, cosine of alpha. Let's just box these so we remember to come back to these in a moment. Now let's go back and think about beta. Let's go back to the original problem. Well, what are we given? We're given that sine of beta is negative 1/2, and beta also lies in quadrant 3. So let's go ahead and think about that on another page. Sine of beta is negative 1/2. Let's write that down. Sine of beta is negative 1/2. Now, that also, you know, also remembering that beta is larger than pi, but less than 3 pi over 2 as well. Okay, now, of course, sine of any angle, that is, well, in this case, sine of beta, is, yeah, they give us negative 1/2, but remember, it's always equal to y divided by r. And r is always positive, and y, because the angle's in quadrant 3, y is negative. So is x. But for right now, we care about the fact that y is negative. So let's go ahead and say, choose rather, that y is equal to negative 1 and r is equal to 2. You see, the individual values of y and r don't matter. What matters is their ratio and their signs. Okay, with these choices, well, I know that x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. So that implies that x squared is equal to r squared take away y squared. And let's see, r squared is 4, and y squared is 1. So we're looking at 3 for x squared. So x squared is equal to 3. Now remember that because we're in quadrant 3, x is negative, and that implies that x has to be, well, the choices were positive or negative root 3, but we need x to be negative root 3 because we're in quadrant 3. Now we already know what sine of beta is, so all we care about is what cosine of beta is. And cosine of beta is, by definition, x divided by r, and so we're looking at negative root 3, that's our x, and the r is 2. Okay? So that's cosine of beta. Let's go back now and put it all together. Now that we know all four values. So we're going to need, let's see, let's go back to the alpha page. We're going to need that cosine of alpha is negative 12 over 13, and sine is negative 5 over 13. Okay, so cosine is negative 12 over 13. So cosine of alpha is negative 12 over 13. And sine of alpha, right here, is negative 5 over 13. I'm just plugging in our results here. Sine of beta was given, that's negative 1/2. And let's see, what was cosine of beta? Let's go back to the beta page and figure out what that is. Or just go ahead and take a look at what that is. Cosine of beta is negative root 3 over 2. So negative root 3 over 2 goes here. Okay, so let's see, a negative times a negative is a positive. It's going to be positive 12 root 3 over 26. And then negative times a negative, but you're subtracting that, so it's going to be minus 5 over 26. And our final answer, let's write that as 1 over 26, factoring that out, times 12 root 3, take away 5. Okay, so this is our final answer. So what's important to notice about this problem is that we never figured out what the angles alpha and beta were, and we didn't have to figure out what sine and cosine of those respective angles were so that we could find cosine of the sum without a calculator. Okay, until next time.